Hello everyone, in this example we're going to talk about another expected value problem. A box contains 8 green and 4 blue marbles. Two marbles are selected at once without replacement. What is the expected number of green marbles among the selected ones? Okay, so again in this problem, since we're dealing with expected value, we have to take it case by case. Okay, so let's see, what's the first case? The case one is we're selecting 0 green marbles, okay? 0 green marbles, right? Because it's possible, theoretically. Now, what is the probability of that happening? Probability of 0 marbles. Well, what's the probability that the first marble will be not a green one? It's going to be, so in total, there are how many marbles? Let's see, 8. Plus 4 is equal to 12. That's total, right? Total. 8 plus 4, 12. Okay, so what's the probability that the first marble selected will be a blue one? It's going to be 4 over 12, right? 4 over 12. And what is the second, what is the probability that the second green, second marble will also be a blue one? Well, it's going to be 3 over 11, right? And why 11? Because it's without replacement, right? It says without replacement, so it means that we discount the one that we already chosen, okay? So 3 divided by 11. And why do we have to multiply? Because the two chosen marbles are independent of each other. That's why there's multiplication here involved. So let's make this simplify it, because 4 over 12 is equal to 1/3, okay, times 3 over 11, that gives us 1 over 11, okay? So now take case 2, 1 green marble, 1 green marble among the two, okay, selected. So what is the probability of that happening, of 1 green marble? So what's the probability that the first marble is green? The first one, it's going to be 8 over 12, okay? And what is the now the probability that the second marble is not a green one, because we're only dealing with one green marble so far, right? So the second one must not be a green marble, so it has to be a blue one, right? So it's going to be 4 over 11. And again, note the fact that there are 11 left because we already chose the green one, right? Okay, now is that the only way that we can have a green marble? Because remember, the green marble might come first, but it can also come second, so we might choose the blue one first and then the second one will be a green one, right? So we have to add the second case, okay? So in other words, the probability will be the same of the different order, right? So if we have the first, the blue one, it's going to be, well, let me just do the algebra. So what's the probability of having the first one as the blue one? It's going to be 4 over 12, and the probability that the second one will be a green one will be equal to 8 over 11, right? So in a sense, you're looking at the same probability for each term, right? Because you see how the 8 can be divided by 11 here first and then 4 divided by 12. So we're just reordering the denominators and numerators, right? Basically. So it's the same probability added twice. So you can think of it as 2 times this probability. It's the same thing if you add them up. Okay, so that's the probability of 1. Now for the final case is case 3. Now the case 3 is to have 2 marbles, 2 green marbles. Precisely, 2 green marbles, okay, and we're selecting only 2, okay, because it says 2 marbles are selected. So now the probability, what's the probability that these 2 marbles selected will all be green? Well, it's going to be simply, the first one will be 2, well, let me do it in a simple, with large numbers first so that you understand it. So the probability that the first will be a green one will be 8 over 12, and the probability that the second one will be a green one will be 7, right? Because there's one less now, 7 over 11 as well. So there's one less in total as well, right? Okay. So as a result, we have what? We can simplify it as 2 over 3 times 7 over 11. Okay, so now that we found their individual probabilities to find the expected value, to find the expected number, we have to multiply the probabilities of individual cases by their respective values, right? So the expected number, or the expected value, will be 0 green marbles times its respective probability, 1 over 11, plus case 2, probability of 1, so selecting 1 green marble multiplied by its respective probability, which will be 8 over 12 times 4 over 11. And let's combine these two because they're the same probabilities by simply multiplying this by 2, right? And then finally, the last case is to have 2 green marbles, so we multiply the 2 green marbles by its respective probability, which it will be 2 over 3 times 7 over 11. And let's simplify that. So the first one turns to 0, the second one, we forgot to simplify the 8 over 12, but in any case, it's 4 over 3. So it's going to be, let's see what's going to give us. So that's 2 over 3 times 4, so that's 4 times 4, 16, I believe. Yeah, so that's 16 over 33 plus, now 2 times 2 is 14. Oh, sorry, 4 times 7 is 28, so that's 28 over 33. So as a result, we have 44 over 33, and we can divide both the numerator and denominator by 11, which is the greatest common factor of 44 and 33, to reduce it, right? And we get 4 over 3. So that's the expected number of green marbles among the selected ones. Okay, that's answer choice E. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in my next video.